We've all had that vivid feeling of remembrance, even though we haven't encountered this familiar situation, right? Well, this occurrence is called déjà vu, the French phrase for already seen. Déjà vu is usually observed in people aged 15 to 25, and is very common among younger children. Currently, scientists have not identified the exact reason déjà vu can occur in young, healthy minds, but there are hundreds of theories justifying this occurrence. Epilepsy is a neurological sickness that behaves similarly to the déjà vu phenomenon, and is characterized by uncontrolled neuronal activation. Once scientists discover the reason déjà vu occurs, they can utilize this knowledge to develop novel treatments for epilepsy, and create technological advancements that will help scientists to better understand how the brain works. So, what exactly is known about how déjà vu occurs? One conjecture explains the process as a mental hiccup in the limbic system. The limbic system consists of several brain areas, including the hippocampus, amygdala, cingulate gyrus, thalamus, and hypothalamus. The limbic system is located underneath the cerebral cortex, where motivation, emotion, learning, and memory are all wired for output. When the eyes process an object, it is immediately sent to the hippocampus as short-term memory, waiting to be converted to long-term memory. Not all short-term memory is converted to long-term, as it must undergo a laborious journey in the brain. According to Scientific American, a short-term memory's conversion to long-term memories requires the passage of time, which allows it to become resistant to interference from competing stimuli or disrupting factors such as injury or disease. Other sources state that there is also an emotional factor that determines what is turned into LTM. That is why you remember experiences like your 6th grade birthday party, rather than what grade you got on your second semester math test in high school. The limbic system interacts with the basal ganglia system, which is important in the formation and retrieval of procedural memory. The present theory is, when STM is on its way to be converted to LTM in the hippocampus, a mental hiccup occurs, and the STM immediately is sent to the basal ganglia system. Instead of the formation of a new memory, the brain comprehends this memory as an old one, and the basal ganglia system retrieves this new memory. As the body takes this new event in, it is perceived as an old event instead of a new one. That is why you feel you've already experienced this event, when the brain just really had like a small hiccup in its conversion process. The theory present has described the process of how déjà vu occurs, but not the small details like, what exactly is the hiccup? What biochemical interactions occur in the brain to achieve this phenomenon? And finally, what neurotransmissions occur between the synapses that carry out the function of feeling déjà vu? Another theory states that déjà vu is just your subconscious mind remembering a dream similar to the event you are experiencing, but this theory has an inadequate amount of proof to support it. Once scientists discover the reason déjà vu occurs, it can be implemented to treat epilepsy, a disease where the victim has excessive or abnormal brain cell activity. And in its most extreme example, grand mal, they get non-stop seizures. Scientists and researchers have discovered that it is possible to stimulate déjà vu in patients who suffer from epilepsy, but no one knows why. In normal patients, the only thing déjà vu can be measured in is the frequency it occurs, where it happens, when it happens, and the age of the participant. Scientists have identified similar instances of déjà vu, but they are not exactly the same. According to sources, presque vu is a feeling of being on the very brink of a powerful insight or revelation without actually achieving this revelation. The feeling is often therefore associated with the frustrating, tantalizing sense of incompleteness or near completeness. On the other hand, déjà rêve is the feeling of already dreamt something that you are now experiencing. Finally, déjà entendu is the experience of feeling sure about already heard something, even though the exact details are uncertain or were perhaps imagined. Déjà vu has rattled the minds of scientists for the past few years, and we are still trying to understand how the brain processes and integrates all of this new information. In further years, younger scientists, such as myself, will take up the challenge to solve the mysteries of the all-too-peculiar phenomenon, déjà vu. But for now, adios!